Jerry Sags and Brian Knobs, the former World Tag Team champs, the Nasty Boys, they want another shot at the belts, and if the past is prologue to the future, and it normally is, we're going to see the Nasty Boys, I think, at some point, Dusty, with the World Tag Team belts around their waist.
Well, this is a very special time on Pride. Two of my favorites, because they do something that we talk about a lot. They do clubbing better than anybody else. Four fists on one man. They do that so well, they are ready, they are tuned, and this is truly a prime cut match of the week. You know what? Maybe I might bring one in both sides that you spin around like on an airplane, helicopter, and it just fly you right off here, and I get another guest. So this is the prime cut match of the week with the Nasty Boys, and I got a good move for you, but I hope I can do it because I'm about to choke to death with this bow tie. Nasty Boys, clubbing time, prime cut, match of the week. Go ahead and finish this. I'll be right back.
It's time for Nasty Sensation! Get ready for Kitty City!
Was there ever any question as to who we're about to see on this WCW Prime Match of the Week, Dusty?
Well, I'm so delighted today. We've seen them all, Sabu, Sting, now the Nasty Boys right here on Prime. Prime Match of the Week, and I guarantee you one thing, Chris Cruz, we will see some clubbing from the Nasty Boys.
That's Jerry Sags, about 6'4". Behind him, Brian Knobs. Well, they're not talking about attitude adjustment for them. They're talking about the adjustment for their opponents. These guys are nonstop, and you are right, Dusty. We're guaranteed to see some clubbering during this match here on the Prime.
Well, I tell you what, they have loved him in circles and hated him in circles. One thing is, a former World Tag Team Champion, but I'll shut up. And the bottom line with that is, as I was saying before I interrupted here by, what's his guy's name?
Either Otis, Apollo, or Ron Vegas.
Yeah.
I don't know.
All right, Otis, Vegas, need to get out of my face. Bottom line is, these guys have been World Tag Team Champions before, and they could be again.
They have won the titles on numerous occasions here at World Championship Wrestling, and they want the gold back. They know it means more money, more prestige, and, well, just more of anything
more
that you want.
More girls, too.
Well, that's kind of what I meant, but I didn't really want to say it. Generally, Sag starts these matches, and just as soon as I say that, Dusty, Brian Knobs, the unconventional one.
I tell you what, in a situation that they're in right here with these two guys right here, they change it up just to get... They're always working on strategy, Chris. And you got to always be doing that. That's why I always tell you, when you leave here, go in a room by yourself and practice talking. And someday you'll be talking like me and stuff, and this thing just come easy.
Oh! Is that a threat?
Oh, you silver tongue, I love you. I tell you what, my mama in Houston love you. Doing great prime match!
Oh, whoa, man! Otis Apollo, we'll call him, goes down. Ron Vegas in the background.
How do you know?
I don't.
Well, you should have listened to the announcer.
Well, you never do.
Oh, look
Jerry
at this
Sags. Ah! Right on the back of the head.
Well, Otis Apollo is over there standing on the apron.
It's either Otis Apollo or Ron Vegas.
And Vegas is in the ring.
So, Ron Apollo?
Yes.
Oh, no! Sags goes in!
Brother, he leveled him.
What a snapping lariat that was. And here comes the pit stop.
He knocked the hole right at the top of his head. Look at this. Look right up here. Look right there. Look like a bald spot, but that's where he hit him. The hair flew off.
That's a bald spot, and you're pointing that out because I have one. Real funny.
Oh, look at this. Oh! Yeah! He's ready for a date now. Got that deodorant on. He's smelling good. And his partner say, I don't want none of that pit stopping.
And Jerry Sags moves in. Sags is the most vicious of the two. Knobs is actually kind of fun-loving, except when he's in the ring, and
well,
then he is all business.
Mean too, and look at this. Ain't fun-loving.
Yeah.
Boom, there he is.
Whoa. He's a guy who can be all smiles when it's not involving pro wrestling. He's a real practical joker outside the ring, but inside the ring, he's serious business, and these guys are a very good tag team.
Here they come. Clubbering! There they are! They're clubbering! Four fists into one guy! That's a super shot of clubbering! Great camera shot! You know what? I bet Diana, producer's down there and was waiting on that. She might even be running that camera. She knows I love clubbering. Right here, the prime match. Okay, it's your turn.
No, I was going to say, I was going to let you run with that. I know how much you love it. And look at the teamwork we've got here, Dusty. Knobs! Oh, man! One, two, and three. And what a maneuver that was. Nasty Boys with a win here on WCW Prime.
Nasty, as we need to be.
In our Prime match of the week.
He's missing the team.
If you have a nasty attitude, step on in, because we'll give you an adjustment.
Oh, yeah, they're ready. They're looking good, too. What a nasty boss.
Now our WCW Prime replay of the week here.
Yes, sir.
Featuring the Nasty Boys. You will take this one, Dusty, I think.
Well, here they go, the Nasty Boys on this Prime replay of the week. And you're going to see this about 150,000 miles an hour, looks like. Boom, boy, just takes his head off. Gets his thing set up right here. The Nasty Boys on top. One of the flying Belindas high above the ceiling. One, two, three. It's over. Nasty Boys victory.
Also known as the Flying Walendas. Yeah. We're back in a moment with word about next week's show. Don't go away. We're the boys. We're the Nasty Boys. Well, Dusty, that does it for this week's edition of WCW Prime. But next week, listen to this. The one and only Nature Boy Ric Flair is here. Harlem Heat, Cobra, Hacksaw, Jim Duggan, the Armstrong Brothers, and a whole lot more, as always, on Prime.
Well, I'd see you about next week, too, when we talk about Prime going all over the world. I said to you, Chris Cruz, if you will bring me a bow tie, I will. Well, you move this down. I will wear this thing for you. I have worn this the whole show, almost choking, almost wanting to flip out of here. I mean, I was back. I was out. You had to bring me water and stuff. But now I have rekindled the fire inside my so-called prime. It's so hot. Nasty Boys looking good. Bottom line here, Christopher Cruz, next week, I am bringing you something out of my closet from Texas. You must wear this thing. And it is red. And it's, I can't tell you. Next week on Prime, Chris Cruz will be dressed like a cowboy in the middle of the night.
Fans, we'll see you next week right here on WCW Prime. Like a cowboy?